Hi everyone, in this video I just want to show you one great extension that I just discovered called Overleaf textarea, which allows you to enable Grammarly inside Overleaf. So as you can see, currently Grammarly is installed as an extension in my browser. I'm using Opera, but I will show you later how to enable and install all the extensions on Chrome. So as you can see, Grammarly here is enabled, but Grammarly is not able to pick up the errors in this text here, and there are a couple of errors. So that's a bit of a problem, because when you're writing a scientific paper or when you're preparing a presentation using LaTeX, you cannot really leverage the power of Grammarly. So sometimes you just have to copy the text and then copy it back, but that's a bit annoying. So there is this tool called Overleaf textarea, which super simplifies the job and is very nice and is very well integrated. So let me just show you a demo. So the tool is already installed here on my computer. It's this extension here. I just have to press here on activate. This creates a page, so you will not see, you will no longer see the PDF version here on the right, but you will see this plain text, okay? And now Grammarly is actually working here. But the amazing thing is that if I Grammarly, first of all, spots the error for me, but then once I click here and I replace this text, the changes will be also sync with the source code here. So let's check here. It says currently replacing. If I click here, replaced, the change will be implemented here on the left, which is amazing. And then I have which states, and then I click here, that states, and again, the changes are implemented here on the left. Once you are done, you can deactivate the tool by clicking here at the top, and then you can recompile the document, and you will see all the changes reflected here in your PDF, okay? A model that states, okay? So now that I've shown you how to use this tool, let me just show you also how to install it on your browser and how to get started with this tool. One simple thing that I would like to ask you, if you found this video helpful, I would like to ask you to just hit the like button below and to subscribe to my channel, which really helps me, okay? So let me show you on Chrome. So currently on Chrome, if you go here on the three dots, more tools, extensions, I do not have Grammarly nor Overleaf textarea installed. So let's install them both. So I go here, I will put this link in the description. Otherwise, just Google it, Overleaf textarea, and you can press Add to Chrome, and this will install it to your Chrome, okay? Now that this extension is installed, so we press here Add Extension, so the extension is installed. We also install Grammarly, so Add to Chrome, and we add the extension to Chrome, okay? If you want to, you don't have to, but I find it quite useful. You can just click here at the top, and you can pin them here at the top, okay? So let's pin this one, Overleaf textarea. So now let's close the browser just to make sure that everything is fine and is working. Let's restart the browser and open Chrome again. So we can just open Chrome again on our computer. And now we can check that we have both enabled, okay? If you click here on Grammarly, you can also check that everything is enabled. So it's just taking a little bit of time, okay? Okay, so it's not okay, let's go here, and then let's click here, and we need to make sure that these are all on, okay? You can also enable this one if you want to. It's not really necessary. So now everything is enabled, so let's disable Overleaf textarea. So we are here in the default page of Overleaf. Let's just type some text, the same one, which has an error, okay? Let's actually do it dynamically. So let's enable this extension. So Grammarly should be now working. It should be checking our text. There are no errors, okay? And now they say there is another models which states that this has already happened. So as you can see, while I'm typing the text, Grammarly is working in the background and is actually checking all and is telling me all my errors in the text. So here there is an error, and you could see that error even here because I misspelled this word. But unfortunately, Chrome is not highlighting that there are a couple of mistakes here, okay? So because is models, so this has to be singular. And then, of course, there is the same error that there was before, that states. So I find it this is amazing because you just can type the source code here for LaTeX, and Grammarly automatically checks your test. Once you're done, you just disable this plugin or this extension, and then everything is ready, and then you're ready to recompile your document, and everything is fine. Of course, you can even recompile the document and change the text, and of course go through all the changes after once you're done, so as we did before. So again, I can enable it right now, and I can spot this error here. It's going to take a second because Grammarly has just to work and check all the text, but then again, same error. I can click here and I can just review all the errors at the end. Thank you very much for listening, and please like this video and subscribe to my channel if you found this video interesting. Thank you very much.